Well, there's sort of divorce proceedings between he and the club. I hope they improve. Resplendent in the Cox Plate Moonee Valley cap, Kevin Bartlett. Welcome, KB.
Thanks very much, Sandy. You told me it was a very casual day. Come relaxed, you said, you know, just put on your shorts and your shirt and put on a hat. Everyone's going to be relaxed. And
I'm glad you are. You've got a collar and tie on. A couple of things I want to talk about before we get down to the nitty-gritty. State of Origin football.
Yep.
You represented Victoria on 20 occasions. There's been a lot of talk in recent times, I guess fuelled by Mark Thompson, who suggested the other day that he would prefer to concentrate on club games, home and away. The club came first. Mm. Your feelings?
Well, look, I've always maintained that your club always comes first. I felt that I really enjoyed playing for Victoria, and it was truly a great honour. But I think my club always came first, and if I had to choose between playing for my club or playing for Victoria, I would have always chosen to play for my club, and that's not to...
You'd ruffle a few feathers now, saying...
Well, that's not to degrade state football. It was a wonderful honour. But my whole football life was generated around the Richmond Football Club, and I just think that even if you ask Teddy Whitten, if you were now to ask Teddy Whitten, or even Bobby Skilton, it'd be interesting to ask Bobby later, that
you're going to tell everyone, choice, all our guests,
no, right? But if they had the choice when they were playing football, and the state selectors said, look, Victoria's playing South Australia today, and at the same time Footscray is playing against Melbourne, or South Melbourne is playing against Collingwood, who do you wish to play for? I personally think they would have said I'd play for Footscray and South Melbourne, because they were brought up also on the club atmosphere. But that's not to say that it wasn't a great honour, and when you play for Victoria, that you give it your best, and it is great to be amongst an elite company of players. But I think this week in the paper it was said at one stage there that what comes first, club loyalties or state duty? And I think that that answers the question. One's a loyalty and one's a duty.
I want to ask you another serious question. You may think it's stupid because you've probably been asked the question 20 times. The highlights of your career.
It's a stupid question.
It is, and think about it very carefully.
Right.
That's all I'm going to say.
The highlights of my career. I would say, and you think I'm going to say the five premierships that I played with Richmond.
I thought they'd be fairly high on the agenda.
Yes. Well, they come second, because the highlight of my career was Junior Supporters Club. That would appear on Channel 7. And I said to Gordon Bennett back in 85, 86 and 87, and Gordon, of course, runs the network now, that put this show on at 5:30 and it'll be an absolute winner, lead you into the news, have huge ratings. I think we were rating 29s at that stage for a Junior Supporters Club, which was the highest rating show on Channel 7 between 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock in its history.
Hey, I've got something
for
you.
And he sacked us.
I've got something for you. Let us go back. Now, just bear in mind, ladies and gentlemen, this was 7 or 8 years ago. This man, a club record holder for Richmond, he has coached a VFL, AFL club. He's won the King of Moomba, and yet he still has the gall and the temerity to perform like this.
Well, if you ever join Junior's Supporters Clubs, get your form from the VFL. Kids, welcome to Junior Supporters Club. Today is the biggest day of my life. Guess what? Sandy Roberts has asked me to go out and interview the Osmond brothers. You know, the pop group, the Osmond brothers, Donnie and Marie. It's going to be very exciting. That's why I've put on all my pop outfits today. The hat, the dark sunglasses. I tell you what, if I can get this job in the band, I'll be leaving the shores of Australia and become a big star overseas. The Osmond brothers and KB. Sounds great, doesn't it? I can hear them. Let's go and find them.
Shouldn't be afraid.
Darling, we're the young ones.
Hey, who are you?
Kevin Bartlett, Junior Supporters Club. This is the biggest day of my life, meeting the Osmond brothers. It's fantastic. It's a thrill of my lifetime, and I'd like to join your group.
The Osmond brothers? We're the Osmond brothers.
You're not the Osmond brothers?
No.
The Osborne brothers? What, you're not in a group? You're not in a band? You're not a singing group?
No, no, Kev, we're the Osmond brothers from Fitzroy.
Thank you.
down the same old strip. I gotta find a new place where the kids are hip.
Oh no, not Kevin Bartlett, Junior Supporters Club, we're in trouble.
Cause it's never been beat, and we've never missed yet with the girls we meet. The guys go steady, cause it wouldn't be right to leave your best girl home on a Saturday night.
Just one more thing, Kevin.
Oh, and you loved every minute of it.
It was a lot of fun. And
CNN are picking up
the old Junior Supporters Club, and they're going to play it on the American cable network.
Was there bitterness when you found that you weren't accepted into a program, perhaps something like Country Practice? Was that a logical step?
Well, no, I wanted my own program to be absolutely correct. And, you know, I hold Gordon Bennett totally responsible for the demise of Junior Supporters.
Well, he dumped it, didn't he?
He dumped it. We had 250,000 members on Junior Supporters Club and went to
air. And that's not counting the international ones. You remember, of course, we had one major guest. Do you remember?
We did.
Well, can I refresh your memory?
We haven't got him, have we?
Let's have a look at this tape.
Fantastic.
Sir. Thank you. Welcome not only to Australia, but to the Junior Supporters Club.
Well, thank you, Sandy, and thank you very much, Kevin, or as you're better known now in the States, KB. It's great to see you. I must say I've watched your program with a lot of interest.
We sent you tapes originally, didn't we?
Yes, the tapes. I can tell you that sitting at the White House that Nancy and I quite enjoy them. But now, of course, we have the special satellite dish.
Live.
Every Saturday night, as it is in the States, we enjoy Junior Supporters Club.
Fantastic.
Especially the star profile.
Yes, of course, that's what it all came from. That was, 8 years ago that the president was able to join us then. He was president of the United States.
Marvelous man.
And is still alive. Only last week he was at President Nixon's funeral. Mm. And this is something that you don't realise, and I'm having dreadful trouble here keeping a straight face, but he has decided with Nancy to fly down. He's here.
He's here.
Welcome. Oh. The President is back. Oh. He is back.
This is fantastic.
Welcome back.
Hey.
Thank you, Mr. Reagan.
Sam. Welcome, Mr. Reagan.
It's wonderful to be here.
We know that you attended the funeral of the late Mr. Nixon and also caught up with the other presidents that are still alive.
I did, and it was good to see Jerry, George, and Jimmy again. And I may be seeing a little bit more of them too, because...
What's happening?
We're the new four directors for the Richmond Football Club.
So
KB, maybe I might be seeing a bit more of you, but after seeing the paper this morning, perhaps not.
Can I just talk about your time in office, Mr. President?
Yeah.
Because you officiated at so many major functions. I guess the one that would stand out for you would be the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles. To have the Games in your own country must have been fantastic.
Sandy, it was wonderful, and I remember the opening ceremony very well when
you
I
spoke?
Got up there and read my speech. And
that was on an auto cue, wasn't it?
Yes.
The Porter prop.
And I remember how it went. I got up there and I said, oh... Oh, oh, oh. And one of my aides came up and said, Mr. President, you're reading the Olympic rings.
Actually, speaking of your age, I know too that you were one of the more popular presidents in days gone by and really kept your finger on the pulse, didn't you?
Well, one of my secretaries reminded me the other day when I saw him. He said, Mr. President, do you realize at one stage you were considered the least informed president in the United States history? And I said, I didn't know that.
Can I ask President Reagan, is it true that because Junior Supporters Club has been picked up on CNN and is going to be shown right across the cable network system,
yes,
that you and Nancy have accepted the role as co-hosts for the program America?
We will be the international correspondents, KB, and
yes,
I'm delighted to hear the news that you just broke exclusively there, that CNN is picking it up, and I can tell you that life for Nancy and I would not be the same without Junior Supporters Club.
Well,
especially those star profiles.
You brought Nancy out with you. Where do you head now? Are you going straight back to America?
No, Sandy, we're going off to New Zealand for a bit of bungee jumping. Then we'll possibly pop into Honolulu for a bit of body surfing on the way back.
It's good to see you again.
It's wonderful to be here.
Thank you, Mr. President.
KB, and the funny thing is, I just saw that clip before. I haven't changed a bit.
No, you have. What about...
You have.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, for joining us. All our best to your wife.
And Sandy's changed, of course, because he wears a toupee now, which he didn't do in those days,
you
of course.
You can't even see the join, can you?
No, it's very, very good. It's one of the best ones.
Okay, that's enough. We've got to take a break. We're going to come back with some sanity. We're going to be talking State of Origin with another of the greats, Bob Skilton.
That's the
Jesse Lenko!
I tipped this.
Oh!